Jennifer Lopez has taken down Elvis. New numbers out just this afternoon show that J-Lo's new song, Get Right, is now number one in England. The hot track leaped over a European re-release of the 1961 Elvis Presley song, Surrender. Get Right is the first single off of J-Lo's brand new CD, Rebirth, which drops here in the States on March 1st. Now, I had the chance to hang out with her, and I discovered this is one woman who is seriously addicted to work. So now we're all going to get up in J-Lo's business, but not in the way you might think. Let's get right to the point. This isn't about J-Lo being a music star or a movie star. And it's definitely not about her love life. I'm talking about a side of Jennifer Lopez you don't hear as much about. J-Lo, the fashion mogul. J-Lo, the restaurateur. J-Lo, the merchandising machine. Yes, whether you knew it or not, J-Lo is an empire.
I don't think of it as an empire.
Okay, so Lopez didn't quite see it that way when I caught up with her in New York City, right as she was about to launch yet another venture.
I think of them as creative passion projects.
You know? Well, then let's take a look at J-Lo's creative passion projects. The first passion is fashion. Lopez co-founded Sweet Face Fashions, which sells the J-Lo line of urban wear and lingerie. And the more upscale Sweet Face line she just unveiled at Fashion Week. There's also a line of J-Lo fragrances, J-Lo Glow, Still, and Miami Glow. And the beauty products, jewelry, and accessories. Altogether, this particular creative passion project does an estimated $325 million in sales. Sure sounds like an empire.
What do you think of this whole J-Lo empire? It's building and building and building.
Well, from one empire builder to another, I can admire it. I have admiration for it. I think it's a beautiful thing, especially when a beautiful woman does it.
J-Lo also has a restaurant on her crowded plate, Madre's, her Cuban-style eatery in Pasadena, California. And she's an investor in the Conga Room, a Latin hotspot in L.A.
Yes, of course, J-Lo's projects keep her extremely busy, but you know what else? They also make her extremely rich. She made Fortune Magazine's list of the richest people under 40. Her estimated worth is $255 million. Not bad for a former fly girl.
With so much going on, how does she find the time to do it all?
You have to love what you do to put so many hours in and to put so much energy into things, and I think I just love what I do.
Is there one part of it that you love more than the other?
I love music, yeah. And I love being an actress. I think for me that will always come first.
Still, J-Lo's business savvy is earning her props from other entrepreneurs who've branched out from the music world.
That's what we do at hip-hop, though. That's the kind of energy we come out of the street, got great imaginations, and nobody's afraid to, like, chase their dream.
And what should J-Lo work on next? This Queer Eye guy has a suggestion.
I think she should design a car, like the J-Lo mobile.
You know what, Carson? That's not a bad idea.
Love the J-Lo mobile. J-Lo's multitasking continues. She's now the subject of an MTV special that's going to air later this week. And I was always under the impression, as many people are, that people just bring stuff to Jennifer Lopez and she stamps her name on it. She said absolutely not the case. And in fact, micromanaging is very important. She gets all in the business.
All right, well, I tell you what, I have a pink J-Lo hat. Every time I wear it, I get nothing but compliments. So the girl's doing all right. She